Welcome back to my channel. I have to be quiet because it's midnight, so let's go. David is still here. WTF is happening. Answer my calls. Mom, David, please stay calm and listen to me. Are your hands and feet on the bed? David, yes. Mom, okay, do not move. He picks up movement and lights. David, he? Mom, the family that lived in our house before us, he had a blind child. One day the child was playing with crayons. He drew all over the walls and made a mess. David. And? Mom. The father was punishing the child. Okay. David. And what? Mom. When the father was punishing the 8-year-old child, the child got scared from his dad yelling at him. David. And? Mom. And so he tried to climb out to the basement window. He ended up falling and hitting his head. He died by accident. Dad. David. Jesus. Mom. That's not even the worst part. They hid his body in the floorboards of the house. Who does that? Like, seriously, that's terrible. Reported him missing. Oh my god, what type of parents are these people? David, why didn't you tell me sooner? Mom, we didn't think he would come back. David, what do I do now? Mom, the blind boy survives by attaching himself to a human. Okay then. The reason he's been grabbing you at night is to see that you're human and not a chair or something. Wow. Right now, you cannot move. My sister is kind of crying in the background. Do not turn on light because that will anger him. David, is he still blind? Mom, yes. But he chose you for some reason and hasn't done that in many years. The last person he chose was his father. David, what happened to his dad? Oh my gosh. So guys, that's the end of today's episode of Yarn. I hope you enjoyed this dramatic experience. Have a great day. See you all next time. Goodbye.